हमारे साथ मौजूद है मिस्टर यश बिरला फ्रॉम द यश बिरला ग्रुप. सर थैंक्स लॉट फॉर जॉइनिंग अस इन जी बिजनेस. इफ यू स्टार्ट योर होल जर्नी व्हेन यू जॉइन बिरला ग्रुप एंड नाउ यू हैव टेकन द कंपनी टू न्यू हाइट, हाउ हैज बीन द जर्नी सो फार?
वेल आई थिंक एनी जर्नी इज फुल ऑफ एफर्ट्स, कन्विक्शन, बिलीफ्स, सर्टन फेलियर्स. इट्स हाउ यू रियलाइज योर गोल्स थ्रू बिलीफ्स इन देम. ऑफ कोर्स इट रिक्वायर्स अ लॉट ऑफ थिंकिंग, प्लानिंग. People are very important, the kind of people you have assisting you, because no organizations are successful just based on one person. It may be leadership qualities which enable you to get good people, but it's a team that works together. And with every setback or what you regard, I won't regard anything as failure, every setback you have in a decision-making process, you have to use it as an opportunity to learn and move ahead without regretting why it happened. Because I think everything in life, including business decisions, happen for a purpose. And with everything, we must learn and move on. That's what I believe.
You mentioned about the failures and the setbacks are part of it. But I mean, now, after reaching to this place, when you look at it, that what are the failures, what are the learnings, how do you feel like?
I always tell you, that's what I've made the statement, that from, I don't regard anything as failure, right? Every experience we have in life or every situation we are faced with is an opportunity to learn, to grow. It's how we analyze it objectively without being emotionally involved with it. Because a lot of our decisions go wrong because we are attached to it for a particular purpose.
Exactly.
So an example could be if I have something, some sector which I feel as a group strategy is not congenial with my long-term view. Even though that sector may exist with me for decades, I may just hive it off. And that requires certain emotional strength. You know, you just feel that certain things you should just carry on because that's the way it's meant to be. But I don't perceive it that way. I think business and emotion should be delinked. Business should be objective because it's, again, for a higher purpose. Not only are you working for the good of that company, you're also working for the good of the group. And there are so many people who are with you in that group. So you can't have your personal emotions interfere with your objectivity. And so that's the way I feel, that every limitation is an opportunity to grow. Some are circumstantial, limitations are beyond your control. But even those circumstances, we are always governed by a lot of things in our life. There are people, there are your decisions, and there's environment, circumstances. You have a recessionary period. The circumstance is beyond your control.
Exactly.
You really can't do anything about
Not
it.
Much.
But in that circumstance, how to be the best you can gives you an opportunity to move ahead when circumstances are favorable. Right. So if you learn to survive in those circumstances, means you're prepared to really prosper in good times. So that is why every negative circumstance also gives you an opportunity to become stronger.
But has there been any event or an, you know, opportunity which you personally on a personal basis?
Of
learning, you mentioned about any particular event or
see, I'll tell you, from the time I joined my business group officially after my late father passed away, I think in the beginning I was a fresh graduate from an MBA school, so I was actually supposed to go for training, but circumstances made you be a decision maker. Now there were a lot of people at that time helping me, and very good advisors I had who helped me through it, but sometimes you realize that unless you make decisions, even if they are wrong, you don't really cross the hurdles, you don't really grow. So it is better you take your decisions yourself,
exactly,
rather than let somebody else take them for you. That did happen in the beginning. A lot of decisions I just took because they were very renowned, very good intentioned advisors. But if you look at it retrospectively, in the long run, they kind of slackened the progress. They kind of slowed down the growth. If you take certain hard decisions which are your own, you may for that time stumble, you may fall, but you'll get up and rise quicker. That's
how it works, in fact. You have, I mean, around a list of 20 companies which you handle, some of them are listed, and the various sectors which you present into, I mean, ranging from IT, education, lifestyle, many of them. But I mean, if we talk about the first of it, IT, let's start with IT. How do you plan to grow, and what's your plan, future plans, a roadmap for that?
Okay, IT basically, I think it's a sector which is very promising for India. Outsourcing of IT services by Western countries is very prevalent. Of course, it has been done. It's not something very new in concept. But it is something which will continuously show increasing trend. It's a space to be into if you want to have a global entity. According to me, any industry has to have a global perspective today. We are living in one world. It's the days are gone where you set up country industries just for your own country.
Exactly.
You have to have a global
perspective.
So an IT is something which is globally required, and India will always have an advantage in IT development. Knowledge skills are good, cost is lower, and Western country continues to outsource things from here. So in a group you have manufacturing entities, you have service entities. So I think it's a combination. It's a service entity which we have created as far as IT is concerned, it's a global perspective, and growth is bound to come in the sector, I feel.
But you'll have your focus here going forward, because that's a growth area.
See, any business we are into, I would say none of them are out of my focus. Some may be small in size, some may be very big in size, some may be medium. Focus is equanimous for all of them. It's the idea is to excel in whatever you're doing. So even if you have a small business, if it manages to have stand out, have a USP, it excels. That would be my endeavor. Whatever you do, however small it may be, it has to stand out. It has to contribute something in its existence and as a perception to people. So that's how I look at it.
We'll take a break on that note and we'll come after break. Aap dekhte rahe Zee Business Aapka Fayda.
ICICIDirect.com presents Aspire, India's first music-to-money college challenge for versatile students of business schools and professional colleges. In association with Maruti Suzuki, Swift and Dish TV.
Ye sari energy aapke mobile phone battery mein. Juice, life, full on.
Easy children.
जी हाँ, माइक्रोटेक इन्वर्टर है तो सब चले बेफिकर.
एक शख्स तीन दिन करोड़ों उम्मीदें.
यू नो मोस्ट ऑफ द जॉब लॉसेस आर नॉट अराइजिंग बिकॉज ऑफ आउटसोर्सिंग टू इंडिया.
अमेरिकी राष्ट्रपति की ऐतिहासिक भारत यात्रा, हर पहलू हर मुद्दे पर नजर. ओबामा इन इंडिया, रात 9 बजे और 12 बजे 8 अक्टूबर तक, सिर्फ जी बिजनेस पर.
ब्रेक के बाद एक बार फिर आपका स्वागत है. हमारे साथ बने हैं यश बिरला. सो थैंक्स अ लॉट अगेन. इनटू अदर बिजनेसेस, एजुकेशन इज वन एरिया विच यू हैव गुड फोकस एंड इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ ग्रोथ पोटेंशियल एंड इट रिक्वायर्स. लुकिंग एट द साइज ऑफ इकोनॉमी इन इंडिया एंड द कंडीशंस हियर, एजुकेशन इज वन सेक्टर विच रिक्वायर्स ह्यूज फोकस एंड देयर नॉट मेनी प्लेयर्स आर प्रेजेंट हियर.
एजुकेशन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अकॉर्डिंग टू मी, इट्स of course, it is a business perspective, and one does every business vertical as a business perspective. But education to me has a far greater meaning. It's a social responsibility. As a family, I think we've always been very supportive of education in this country, because education is required parallelly with a growth of any economy. And with the growth of every economy, education demand is likely to go and the supply is likely to grow. Quality of education is very important. To me, you're preparing a generation for tomorrow. The way you teach them, the way they grow up, a lot depends on their parenting, a lot depends on their schooling, education, college, universities. So the quality of education is very responsible. We want to create a generation of tomorrow which is responsible, which is progressive, not only academically and professionally, but also personally. So that is, one is that it's a great business, because we are in a developing economy and the demand and supply, demand will continue to grow, supply will never be able to really equal the demand.
Not match up anything.
It will not be able to match up, because the illiteracy rate is pretty high. Government is giving a lot of support to education institutions, it's having a lot of social programs in its budget for encouragement.
But what's your expansion plans there?
In education, it is actually a very aggressive expansion plans. We are in the entire spectrum of education. So we are in play schools, we are in K-12 schools, we are in K-12 includes international curriculum, Indian curriculum, CBSE, ICSE, whatever. We are going to get into universities, so that is post-12 education. We are getting into education systems, so there's software for education management to track a complete progress of a child's education career life from nursery to the time he graduates. We have ways of how a child can excel in whichever aptitude he has. So as parents, we say that our children should become good in art, or they should be good in as a scientist or a doctor. But a child has its own aptitudes. What are those aptitudes? How to harness them, make them flourish?
Your plan for universities on track as of now?
Yes, we have plans for universities on track. They are on the anvil. Our other plans have already gone into brick and mortar stage. That's the Praise Schools and the K-12 schools. Construction's already started. Some are already in existence. Universities are at the level where they are going to just start execution any.
So when do we see your university running?
I think definitely in the next, within the next 3 years. That includes construction and everything.
On track.
Yeah.
Education, I mean, after education, I mean, we spoke about your IT business, we spoke about your education business. Another important business, and from your perspective and from country's perspective as well, is power.
Yeah.
I believe you have huge expansion plans. Recently also you did some expansions there.
Yeah.
Some of your projects are on.
Yeah, power for me is, of course, again, with every developing economy, the demand for supply will of power will far exceed its supply.
Again, deplies.
And to me, power, harnessing from thermal power projects is limited. There is a limitation. Coal availability is a limitation. Alternate green power generation sources will always be welcome today, especially with the world and the pollution problem facing, and the awareness of a green world which harnesses natural resources to the best of its capabilities. To me, hydropower is a good opportunity. To me, waste power generation is a good opportunity. Solar power, I think, is one of the strongest opportunities we have, because that's a natural element which is available in abundance. So it's that part of it is what we are focusing in, is solar power. But we are also going to have a presence in other power units, whether it's thermal power, whether it is any other alternate sources of power.
Nuclear also, you're looking at it?
No, we're not looking at nuclear. Something which I don't really believe in as of today. It's definitely a great sector to be in, but I would rather be focusing on these areas which I just
told you. I mean, you have announced recently some projects in solar power. Are they on track? Where are they?
Absolutely on schedule. We are going to have solar power generating units, which are as per the state government and central government schemes. Our applications are already well underway, and we've bought land in certain places. We also have a plan of getting into solar power development as far as photovoltaic cells are concerned. These are all, basically, we want to be in the entire spectrum of solar power. That's an idea.
Lifestyle is another business where you are present. But in terms of revenue generation or revenue contribution to your total group, how does it perform?
By lifestyle, you mean health?
Health, spa, everything.
Okay, health is one sector. I call it health sector. We are not really in the lifestyle sector, because lifestyle includes a lot of other things. We are basically in the health and wellness sector.
Exactly.
Health and wellness, by saying we are in the, again, I, if you see my philosophy, it's to be in the complete, if any vertical I'm into, I would like to be in the complete spectrum. So health and wellness belong to that philosophy as well. In the sense, I'm into alternate health remedies, which is Ayurveda, naturopathy, spas, Ayurvedic medicines, OTC, generics, and prescription oriented. Plus, we are into cosmetology, dentistry, and into hospitals. I have hospitals presently being run under charitable trusts.
Okay.
They're commercially viable, but the income is given to charity, because we always feel there's a social cause as far as health is concerned. But if you see, we are in the complete spectrum of health, and health again is one area which is this country is highly deficient in. Whether it is the Western sciences or whether it's Indian sciences, they have enough scope in this country to grow. Western sciences will always be required, hospitals will be required, because there's a dearth of them. Indian sciences, I think things like Ayurveda, they've lost emphasis down the centuries. I do believe there's a very strong science we have in our culture tradition, which is scientific. But nowadays people perceive it as, you know, some mom and pop remedy. That's not the case. There's a science behind it, and our endeavor would be as a group to kind of reinstate the conviction of people back into the science of it.
But I mean, hospitals, as you said, do you plan to look at it commercially? Because you have it in the charitable, yeah. But plan to look at it commercially going
yes,
forward?
Yes, we actually have a planned joint venture with Apollo Hospitals.
Okay.
Which is the first, it's supposed to come up in Thane. Mm-hmm. It's already at the state where it has to start construction. So that's a commercial venture.
And any plans forward there? I mean, any more hospitals?
That's as for now. And then we will see as, because as I told you, we also have a cosmetology and dentistry section. Mm-hmm. That can always go into forward integration to more services. Mm-hmm. Daycare hospitals, maybe stay care, yeah. Depends on that.
So that's the plan for the time being.
Yes.
On that note, we'll take one more break. Aap dekh rahe hain ye business aapka fayda. Break ke baad ek baar fir aapka swagat hai. Hamare saath bane hue hain Yash Birla. Many businesses we spoke about. Textile infrastructure is another. And infrastructure is a key to India's economic growth.
Yeah.
Your expansion plans in that sector?
Textile, we've got a spinning entity since
cotton.
Decades, which is synthetic. What we've gone into is cotton spinning. We are, again, over there also from start to finish. So we have ginning, which is the first stage. You're spinning. We have a weaving mill, which is ready for execution. Weaving mill will continue to processing, dyeing, and ultimately retailing with our own branded garments. So it'll be from cotton to garments. So it's like completing the whole spectrum of mm-hmm. textiles. We are presently increasing our spinning capacity as well. So that's something which we need to get into economies of scale. And we are ramping that up. And then it's going into forward integration as well.
Forward integration in terms of?
In the sense it will go into processing, which we are not into today.
Okay.
Garmenting and retailing, which we are not into today. So that will go into forward integration.
Do you look, I mean, a significant contribution of the revenue coming from retail and because that's a
of course, the value addition, the maximum is in retailing. That exactly. depends a lot on brand building, advertising, you know, all these kind of things happen in that. So obviously we have it in our plan, but we are not executing it right away. We're waiting for the right time till we have economies of scale in our backward processes to go into that.
And when do we see that?
I think within the next 18 months, I would say.
18 months in terms of the retail part of it. And infrastructure?
Infrastructure is again one of these industries which I have strong conviction in. Again, this country, infrastructure is going to be really required. Yeah. The way we are progressing, unless the infrastructure supports it, that progress will be meaningless. I think the existing giants of infrastructure also believe that there a lot of people can come in, there'll still be demand. In fact, they are only saying, you know, everybody should come in because there's so much demand. Everybody's finding it difficult to complete. So, of course, we've been in infrastructure, but in a very personal way. We have a lot of land banks we inherited through generations to develop those land banks, real estate mostly. Development and selling, we've been in it as a group. We would like to do it now commercially, that part, and also construction of bridges and roads. Because I think that's something which is very concrete. It's a very steady industry. It's not cyclical because it will always be in demand. There will always be an outlay by the government. And it's a sector which I think I would like to be present in.
Presently, you don't have a significant presence, right, today?
Not in infrastructure at all. It's only in real estate. Mm-hmm. But we would like to get into infrastructure. What we are doing is we are, of course, I'm already making a team. We're kind of in talks with the base industry for some kind of acquisition who's got a bit of a track record. On that, we will add our team which we have created and then we will move ahead.
So you're looking for a domestic acquisition in that
that's
space?
Right. That's right.
And when do we see that plan coming in?
In the next 3 months.
The next 3 months?
Yeah, so we've already identified certain things. It's all ready to be structured. You know, we've been working on it since last almost a year, so now it's ready to be executed.
So very soon we'll hear something from you on that note. Yeah. But I mean, you spoke about various expansion plans over various of the business and all this business actually requires huge money. You've yeah. raised money in the past, but I mean, if you talk about raising money from markets going forward, you have any plans?
Of course, as and when it is required to raise money from the market, we've always accessed the markets whenever there's a requirement. We have our own internal generations. As you know, as I told you, we have certain assets which we've developed or we've hived off. And through that, the internal generations have kind of funded whatever our share of the contribution is required. Some are privately held, so they don't require public money. They'll continue to go from these internal generation sources. But wherever, whichever company is publicly listed or where our internal generations are not enough to meet the long-term growth plan, we will be accessing the public.
But I mean, any figure in mind right now that you need so much of money for all your businesses to grow or...
Honestly, firstly, how I look at it, I personally look at each business requires that X amount of capital. This is the capital which I'm ready to attribute to the business. This is the kind of capital that business is able to generate in its revenue. And this is the money I require from outside. I don't like to look at a total figure because that total figure leads you not to be objective or
kind of misleading.
Yeah, because then you'll say, "Oh, let us compromise there. Let's do something here." I don't like that.
You are also looking at some of the equity players in some of your businesses, in some of your products, especially Power, if I'm not wrong.
To be honest, we are open to any kind of associations where it can add value to our existence and to our business growth. We have not really finalized with any equity players as of today, but there are talks. People have shown interest, but till it adds to our growth and harnesses our potential, I don't feel any association is really meaningful to me. It should give value to me, then only I would finalize it.
Do you feel there is a lag or there is a space where you want to fill in for the whole group and okay, this is the particular sector which you're not present today, or maybe you like not today, 2 years, 3 years down the line, you will like to go inside?
You see, more or less the sector which we've spoken about in our discussion, there is so much scope in those sectors to grow. These have evolved after a lot of thinking, deliberation over the last few years. And these are the sectors we would like to be in. And I would like to focus on these sectors, really do full justice to them, to get economies of scale, because there's so much growth potential in each of them.
So
as far as I'm concerned, if you ask me today, I have nothing else in mind. Right, but of course we are businessmen, and whenever opportunities come up, we are ready to take them if they give you value, if they give your group value, as far as money, positioning, and presence is concerned. But as of today, no. These are the sectors I want to be in, and these are the sectors I feel there's enough growth for me to put my efforts, time, and funds into.
But in terms of revenue contribution, where does your maximum contribution come from? Which part of the business?
Well, as of today, it's mainly from the manufacturing sector, because they've been the industry which have been existing for a long period of time. But service sectors always, as revenues are smaller than a manufacturing sector, but margins will probably be higher.
Much better.
But they also take some time to evolve, right? Because you have to be able to be patient for them to really take off. They'll require a lot of brand building, a lot of acceptability, a lot of innovativeness. So these kind of things take some time to really, be able to give you the rewards. So since you've got into them much more recently compared to the manufacturing, I think these things are things of the future. And I don't really compare the two. Mm-hmm. Because I would like to be present in all these sectors. It's not that I'm going to compare
exactly
which is giving you more. As I told you, even small businesses, if the revenue is lesser, can give you much more satisfaction, because they will be able to be distinctive compared to any other business which may be much larger.
We spoke enough about your business. Now, if we just have a question or two on your personal life, you spend most of your time with business also. But, I mean, apart from that, what kind of hobbies do you have which the public at large doesn't know about?
I don't know what doesn't the public know, because I think more or less, indirectly or indirectly, a lot has been spoken by me and whatever is perceived. I hope I have more time to pursue my hobbies and put greater emphasis on them. Hobbies, if you say, it's a very systematic daily existence of mine. I exercise every day. I'm very much into health and fitness. I have only healthy food. I like to eat food at home. I hate eating out food. Mm-hmm. I'm a pure vegetarian. So I like ghar ka khana. I don't drink at all. I've never tasted alcohol. So I'm on a very health trip basis. I think external health is linked to internal health, mind, body, spirit. It's also linked to your professional
health. Yoga?
I do yoga, yes. I do pranayama, I do meditation. I read only philosophical books,
Okay. Spiritual
books. You can say those are my hobbies. I'm very fond of my children, my family. I spend a lot of time with them. Playing games, mundane games with them, whatever entertains them and makes me spend time with them, I do. So between all this and whatever other kind of pastimes I have, maybe watching a film, spending some time with my friends, I really don't find time to do much more. But in each of this, I would like to spend more time. I would like to spend more time in doing reading good books, spiritual, philosophical books, spend more time in yoga, meditation, traveling to places which give me, which progress me as a human being, which give me progression as a human being. I don't have enough time, unfortunately.
I think the last part of it, the public at large doesn't know about it. Anyways, I mean, that Yash Birla likes ghar ka khana and likes reading.
I've spoken about it enough, but I don't know. Maybe that part is not highlighted.
I'll do it definitely. Yeah. Thanks a lot anyways for joining us.
Thank you.
Nice.